Hello students, welcome to our today lesson. It is Unit 6, Lesson 4. Our today lesson is about more on circles. Students, before we start deeply, let's go further in our today lesson. What do you understand from our topic, our today lesson about more on circles? Is there new thing that you don't know? I hope that you are familiar with circles. So we are learning today what you have learned before and add only some extra. So please prepare yourself for our today lesson. What is circle? Now let us see. In this, we will learn circles and the lines associated with them. In our today lesson, we will learn circles and the lines associated with them. What do you remember from the lines that's associated to the circle? Also, we'll learn circles and the angles associated with them. What type of angles can we form from the circle? Can we get inside the circle? At least how many times? In what way can we calculate that is? But before we start this part, this topic, this point is, now let us say what is circle. Do you remember what circle was? Can you define? Students, I hope that you are familiar with circle, and any one of you can draw. Now, circle is a plane figure in which all points are equidistant from a given point called center of the circle. Circle is made up of many points, but that points are what? Equidistant from a given point called center of the circle. Now let us see. Assume that this is what? Center O. So the points that make the blue line, the blue curve is, are what? Are many points that are quite distant from this point. Gobo, Wabaro, Urusan, Ofoganis Leguchira, Hey, Bermagurana, Barta Hudunta. Okay, now let us see. Before we extend our lesson is, what you recall about parts of circle? What do you recall from? Can you tell me, let us see this figure, and what can you recall? Can you tell me what is called the line segment AC? Look, AC, what is it? Do you remember the name? Okay, what about AD? The line segment from A to D that passes through the center of the circle. What is it? Do you remember what is called, what name we give A, B, C? The three points on the circle, A, B, C. They make what? Something, not a straight line. So what name do we call that? Haye, mashayi kartan waxa loogu yeero C, X, D. Mashayi kartan xagasha A, O, C, waxa ay tahay? A, O, C, xagasha noocaas oo kale maxaa la oran jiray lagu magacaabi jiray ma xasuusataan? I hope that you have learned in grade 9 as well as in your grade 8 maybe. Okay, what about the angle C, A, D? Xagasha C, A, D oo kale ma xasuusataan magaceedu wuxuu ahaa? Do you remember what the name of the angle C, A, D? Okay, now what do we call AYD? How can we call AYD? Okay, now let us see these things. Because what you have learned in your previous classes will help you in this class. Also, what you learn in here will help you in the future. Now, AC is called chord. AC, the line AC. The line segment AC is called chord. So chord begins on the circle, ends on the circle. Chord go, per bilowgis wa gobada dusheeda, per dhammaadkiisu wa gobada dusheeda. Okay, again AD is called, again AD is what? It is a chord, wa chord. Lakin chord igan muxuu kala loogu yeeri karaa diameter, wa dhexroor. Waayo wuxuu maraa xudunta gobada ayuu dhex maraa. Oo laba gacan ayuu ka kooban yahay isagu. It consists of two radiuses. Okay, angle AOC, angle AOC is called central angle, isn't it? Okay, the force angle CAD, CAD is called inscribed angle. So you have already learned these terms. That is why I have started by asking you, in what way can we name this? That is why I said to you. Okay, ABC is called an arc. ABC, arc, wa qanso. ABC wa goobada qayb kamida, wareegi goobada qayb kamida, qaybtaas waxaan oran karnaa wa qanso. Arc, but this arc is called minor arc. Qanso yar weey. Arc ABC is written as ABC over it hat. Waxaan u qori karnaa ABC intaan xaraf saddexdi xaraf ee u taagnaa goobada dusheeda ku dul yaalay intaan qorno ayaynu korka koofiyad camal oo kale ka saaraynaa. Qaansadii calaamad u dhigantoo kale ayaynu qoraynaa way ka dhigan tahay. Okay, AYD is called semicircle. AYD, goobadan markaad eegtid, waa barhkii goobada weeye. Goobada barhkee. The word semi itself is what? Half. Half of the circle. Okay, AYC, haddana waa maxay? AYC, waa qayb ka mid ah haddana wareegii goobada. Oo qaybtaas maxaan odhanaa taa maxaan ugu yeedhinaa major arc baynu ugu yeedhinaa waa qaansada weyn qaansa weyn kolka hadda maxaynu halka ku baranay we have learned what we call minor arc what we call major arc what we call semicircle semicircle is what half of the circle 180 degree when we say minor arc less than 180 degree arc waa xagal waa qaansa ka yar 180 degree haddii 180 degree maxaan odhanaa semicircle haddii ka badan tahay 180 degreena waa major arc That is. Okay, now let us see the most important part of our today lesson. Our today lesson is angles and arc is determined by lines intersecting inside and on a circle. This is the lesson that we are going to learn. So the main point is of our today lesson started. Waxaynu baranaynaa oo hadda inoo bilaabmay xaglaha iyo qaansooyinka ay sameeyaan xariiqaha ku kulma goobada dhexdeeda iyo goobada dusheeda. Goobada dhexdeeda waxaa laga yaabaa xariiqo inay ku kulmaan, xariiqahaas laga yaabaa inay xagla sameeyaan, xaglihii ay sameynayeen baynu ku baranaynaa halkan. Sida loo helayay, qiimahoodu wuxuu noqonayay. Sidoo kale waxaa laga yaabaa xariiqaha goobada dhexdeeda ama dusheeda ku kulmaya ama isku jarayay in ay sameeyaan qaansooyin. Qaansooyinkaas ayaynu baranaynaa. So this is the main point of this topic, of this lesson. Now let us see. In a circle, an inscribed angle is an angle whose vertex lies on the circle. And whose sides are what? Chords of the circle. Students, ardayay, try to understand this and draw by your own. Maxaa la yidhahdaa inscribed angle? Inscribed angle waa xagasha vertex-keedu ku dul yaallo goobada dusheeda. Dhinacyada xagashaasna ay noqonayaan chords. That means, already you know, but this is. So you can put in figure form. Let us see the figure form. This is. Now AD and BD, they intersect on D. D is on the circle. Now it is formed, it forms what? An angle, angle D. So this type of angle is called an inscribed angle. xalidaada xagasho noocano kala ee ay sameeyaan laba koordi oo ku dul kulma boobada dusheeda inscribed angle. Okay. So angle ADB is an inscribed angle, an inscribed angle. Okay. What arcs do we have in here? Waxaa jira meesha laba qaanso ayaa jira hadda haddayn meel. Qaansada ACB oo ay ka soo horjeedo xagashii inscribed angle-ka ahay iyo xagasha inscribed angle-ka qaansa ay ku dhex jirto oo ah ADB. Now, these arcs we will name them. Subtended arc, inscribed arc, intercepted arc. These are terms that we will use in these lessons, in this chapter, in this part, or so we should have to understand them. Now, angle ADB is inscribed in the arc ADB. Again, we could actually have ADB, we could actually have ADB. So we will call it inscribed in the arc. Find the angle, when, the arc which this angle is inscribed. Adil wadil wadado, shag amahel, and hagashani, qansada ay ku dhex jirto waa tee, waa ADB, qansada ADB ay ku dhex jirtaa. Haye, again we can call angle ADB subtended by arc ACB. Subtended. Arcigi hore maxaa nidhay inscribed in that arc. This one we will say subtended. Okay, also we can say arc angle ADB intercepts arc ACB. Arc ACB. Intercept marka aanu leenahay dhinacyada xagasha ayaa sameeyay ka dhigan tahay. Qaansadaas ayaa gooya. X intercept, Y intercept, do you remember? Yes, just like that. So, haddaynu garanay oraahyadan sida aynu u kala isticmaalino oo aynu fahanno, waxa kale oo dhan noo dhib yaraanaya. Now let us proceed and see the measure of a central angle. This is central angle. O is the center of the circle. So OB and OQ are the sides of the angle. BXQ is the subtended arc, isn't it? Intercepted arc, isn't it? Now, what do we call OB and OQ? They are radiuses, isn't it? Radiuses. Waxaan oranayna OB, xariijinta OB, barta xudunta ka dhaqaaqda, waxaana ku dul dhammaataa goobada dusheeda, waxaan oran karnaa oo nagu yeedhaynaa maxay gacanka goobada, isn't it? So now, this is central angle. So measure, the measure of a central angle is the measure of the arc it intercepts. So measure of angle BOQ is equal to measure of arc BXQ. Hagasha habirka ama baaxada hagasha BOQ waxay la mid tahay baaxada ama cabirka qaansada ka soo horjeeday ee uu. That is. How was it? Isn't it simple? Now we have learned one very important theorem. The measure of an angle inscribed in a circle is half the measure of the arc subtending it. Hadihe, inscribed angle if we have, it will be half of the arc it intercepts, half of the arc it subtends. Let us apply this, let us use and see this example and solve it by using the theorem and what we have learned here. In the figure below, O is the center of the circle. Find the values of X and Y. Wow, this is. So, look well the figure. First read, then understand, then you will go to the solution. Now, can you tell me what we are asked? We are asked X and Y, isn't it? What are they? What type of angles are they? Are they inscribed angles? Are they central angles? In what way can we find? You should have to get this before you start. So now, I hope that you can guess. Now let us see the solution. Solution, both X and Y are inscribed angles, so their measures are what? Half the measures of the arcs subtending them. So what is the arc? To find the Y, we must get what? Which arc? Saanu hagasha Y ama qiimaha Y aynu soo saarno qaansadeebaan loo baahan yahay in qiimaheeda garano. si aynu eega soo soo saarno qaansadee loo baahan yahay inaan garanno. Waayo waxaan idhi inscribed angle-ku waa badhka ama half-ka qaansada ka soo horjeeda. Now, we can say y is equal to 1 over 2 measure of arc ABC. Y qaansada ay ka soo horjeeda ama ay ka baxsan tahay waa ABC, qaansada ABC. Badhka qaansada ABC ayaa noqonaya qiimihii y. Haddaba ABC mad haysataa? ABC wuxuu la mid yahay qiimaha central angle-ka, xagga xudunaadka inbuu la qiimayay. So it will be equal to 65 degree. Half of 130 degree is 65 degree. So arc ABC is 130 degree. Haye, to find the agas, what must we do? Again, agas is equal to half of what? Half of the measure of arc, which arc? ABC. Isn't it? Let us say agas is equal to half of the measure of arc ABC. Do you have? Since the circle is 360 degree, when ABC is 130 degree, then the other arc APC will become 230 degree. Half of 230 degree will become 115 degree. How it was, students? I am sure it was so simple. Now let us go and try to see the other parts of this. Another example. In the figure below, if central angle A or B is a right angle, find the degree measures of angle ACB and angle ADB. Let us see the figure. This is the figure. See it well, try to understand it, and so on. This angle AO is 90 degree. So you are expected to find angle ACB, again to find angle ADB. Similar to some extent the previous. So I am sure that you can answer it easily, in easy way. Okay, now let us see the solution. Solution, from this figure we can understand that, from this figure what can you get? What are the angles ACB and angle ADB? Okay, what is the measure of angle and arc ADB? So we can understand that measure of arc ADC is equal to 90 degree. Why? What is the reason? Arc ADC is equal to 90 degree because it is opposite to the central angle, 90 degree. Now also measure of arc ACB, the remaining arc of the circle will be 270 because when we add the two arcs, it must give us 360 degrees. It's full circle, complete revolution. Now, since angle ACB and angle ADB are inscribed angles, therefore, measure of angle ACB will be half of the measure of arc ADB. Measure of arc ACB will be half of 90 degrees, which is equal to 45 degrees. And measure of angle ADB will be equal to what? Half of measure of arc ACB, which is equal to half of 270 degrees, which is equal to what? 135 degree. Up to now, we were discussing only what? Only inscribed angles and central angle. These are the angles that can be formed inside the circle. Up to now. Okay. Corollaries. What are corollaries? Corollaries are points that are derived from the theorems. So let us see these corollaries. The first corollary says, corollary one, an angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. Can you draw this? The angle is inscribed in where? In a semicircle. So that angle must become how much? It must become a right angle. Hagasha kudah jirta qaanso goobada barkeedi waxay cabirkeedu yahay 90 degree. It is 90 degree, isn't it? Now let us see the figure. This is the figure. So this angle to find it will be half of AAC. Is it ADC? Half of the arc ADC. Arc ADC is equal to how much? It is half of the circle, so it is 180 degree. Half of 180 degree is 90 degree. And 90 degree is a right angle. Okay, corollary 2. An angle inscribed in arc less than semicircle is an obtuse angle. Do you remember what obtuse angle was? An angle greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, isn't it? So if there is an inscribed angle which is inside an arc less than semicircle, it will become obtuse angle. Look at the figure. This angle will be what? 90 degrees above. The angle ABC will be 90 degrees above. So it's obtuse angle. And the last corollary 3, it says an angle inscribed in an arc greater than semicircle is an acute angle. Students, try to prove this by your own and try to read more about these parts. Now, let us see activity. Let us see how much you get from this lesson. Let us see. Using the figure below, find the values B, Q, X, and Y. Let us see the figure. The figure is this. Look well, mark well. It may take more time, but what I want is what? At least find BQ, at least. When you didn't use your time, find at least BQ. So you have 3 minutes. Good luck. Well, welcome back again. Let us see together. I hope that you have tried. Now, let us try to solve together and check your answers. Solution, this is the figure we have. Angle Y is inscribed angle. All the angles we are asked, B is inscribed angle. Again, Q is inscribed angle. X is inscribed angle. All the angles that we are asked are inscribed angles. So we should have to know the arc they intercept, isn't it? So now we will say B is equal to 1 over half of measure of arc ED. Arc ED, where is it? So mark ED. Do we have arc ED? How much it will be? Imsa noqon kartaa balqaansada ED cabirkeedu? Yay iska soo horjeedaan xagasha 30 degree AB ayay ka soo horjeedaan. Sidaas daraadeed xagasha aan qaansada ED waxay noqon kartaa 60 degree, 60 degree. Half of 60 degree will become 30 degree again. So B ED will be half of 60 degree and it will become 30 degree B. Angle, the market angle B is 30 degree. Q is equal to half of measure of arc ED. Look again, Q. Where is Q? Do they have the same arc? Yes, they have. Again, this also 30 degree. Intercepted arc is ED again the same. What about X? X is equal to half of measure of arc BC. Arc BC is how much? Where is BC? Okay, yes, it is over C to the 40 degree angle in E. So if this inscribed angle is 40, the intercepted arc will become how much? 80 degrees, isn't it? Half of 80 degree. Half of 80 degree. Which is equal to 40 degree. What's left for us? Only the value of y. And you can find easily the value of y. Y is equal to half of arc DC, and arc DC is 124 degree, which is equal to half of 162 degree. Okay, I hope that you get these answers. Those who didn't get, please try to discuss with your friends and the one in around you. That is all for our today lesson. Students, work hard. The more you read, the more you understand. The more you try, the more you get. More practice makes you perfect. Good luck. Bye-bye.